FPGA, embedded applications. We have a great example over here with the USB 3.2. And I'm here with Paresh Patel. He's the CEO of SLS. And we're here at the Embedded World in Germany at the Altera booth. Can you explain your great case? How do you use FPGAs?
Thank you so much, Roland. Great to be here. And System Level Solutions is a product design and development company. And we make IP cores, boards, software, do all the support. And what we're showing is for different industry applications basically in robotics, in industrial control, in test and measurement, and in automotive, where you have a lot of data ingest coming through various systems. And what we're doing is we're showing an IP core that can take that can be placed inside an FPGA, basically taking the data ingest and creating and doing follow-on analysis.
And how can you use AI in it? Because AI is one of the great features from the FPGAs.
Yeah, so suppose you have a camera and you're getting a lot of data. In this particular case, let's say if we're getting 4K data. Sure. So that's a lot of data for the AI ML data sets to be created. Sure. So what you can do is subsample that, still send the big stream to a compute device, but then you can do AI inferencing in the FPGA and get make decisions, on-the-fly decisions based on that.
And you have applications, you showed me some examples. Can you explain how that works then in practice?
Yeah, so in practice, what we have is a demo here that shows that we have a board that we have an Altera Agilex system. Then we have a USB board and basically connected to a PC. And this is basically generating a 4K video stream. And that 4K video stream at 60 frames per second is being shoved to the PC at about 7.4, 7.5 gigabits per second. So people get an idea of how you can take large data and put it to a compute device very quickly over USB.
And one of the biggest challenges is how to get the updates, because after half a year, you have either a new driver or you have a new algorithm. How can you update?
Yeah, so that's the beauty of FPGAs, they're reconfigurable. Mm-hmm. So once, if there's an update, let's say in the IP core, then you can recompile the system and then on the fly, put it back into the system and get it up and running. So you can do mechanisms like firmware over the update, over the air updates, and then, or just directly connect to a PC, update your system, and you're good to go again.
I think it's a great example of an FPGA.
Yeah.
Paresh, thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Roland.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you for watching here from the Embedded World in Germany at the Altera booth. Thank you.
Thanks.